Hey, 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 how you guys doing? Money Smart Guy Matt Cipolla here, hailing to you from Dallas, Texas. And I'm not sure if you know this, but we relocated from Oak Brook, Illinois, down to Dallas, Texas. Why move to Dallas, Texas? Well, it's understanding opportunities and creating a new financial reality. Because one thing I know for sure, life-changing moments don't happen in your existing environment. I'll discuss why in this episode of the 7-Figure Squad, happening in 3, 2, 1, let's go.
Never short stopping, now I'm winning like I'm Jeter. Steady through the rigor, yeah, I'm getting bigger. Just fighting in them trenches, now I'm making 7 figures like.
What's cracking, everybody? Money Smart Guy Matt Cipolla here, hailing to you from Coram Park here in Addison, Texas. And as I mentioned earlier, I'll be discussing in this episode how millionaires create a new financial reality by identifying new opportunities. But before we begin this episode, I'd like for you to put down in the comment section below your affirmation saying, I am becoming a first generation cash flow millionaire. Put in the comment section below. I am becoming a first generation cash flow millionaire. With that being said, I also want to remind you that our next goal here of the 7-Figure Squad YouTube channel is to get to 150,000 subs. Why? Because we want to bless a church, charity, or nonprofit $5,000 once we reach 150,000 subs. So if you'd like to help create that reality for that church, charity, or nonprofit, please hit subscribe if you haven't done so already, or please share this with somebody that has never heard or seen or watched any of our YouTube videos here on the 7-Figure Squad. Now, without further ado, let's get into today's episode. Now, some of you were with us back in December during Vlogmas 2020, where we discussed the parable of the sower. It was a short story about how a farmer or a sower was going about planting seeds in 3 different pieces of ground or land to grow a harvest, to enhance opportunities. Well, my main point in sharing that parable is that even if the best seed is planted in the wrong soil and the wrong ground, and worse, not cultivated, that seed will never return a harvest. Or worse, it will return a limited harvest, never realizing that seed's full potential. So let's translate this to business and your finances. You can have all the know-how in the world in terms of running your business, budgeting, finance, savings and investments, and creating cash flow. But if your environment is not a good one, or the industry of which you're working in is not a conducive one for success, then you can kiss your multi-million dollar dreams goodbye. And you're saying, man, I'm so confused. How do I know that my environment or my industry or my career or business is good for me to optimize my opportunity and maximize my potential to become a first generation cash flow millionaire? Well, that's why I'm here. I'm going to explain how I process things through 3 simple steps, 3 different categories to help me realize a most logical, less emotional, and most rational explanation of making moves. Along with these categories, I'm going to give you some questions with inside these categories to help you make your multi-million first generation cash flow millionaire dreams come true. Category number 1, where do you live? So what state do you live in? What are the laws of that state? Are they business friendly? Do they incentivize work and creating opportunities for other people? What neighborhood do you live in? Are there lots of businesses in the area? Who are your neighbors? What schools can you or your children go to? Where are your opportunities? What is your career and business opportunities in another state? Are you spending a lot of time traveling, necessary and unnecessary? You know, it's often said that you learn about a relationship not during the good times, but more so the bad times. You see, for my wife and I and our family, COVID-19 and the pandemic, and worse, the lockdown, the shutdown, explain to us what we really needed to know about Chicago, Illinois, its surrounding suburbs, and the state of Illinois. We're experiencing many different things. Rising property income taxes, primarily because the state did a horrible job in managing pensions, and therefore taxing the homeowners and property owners for that mismanagement. Furthermore, many of the common things that we spend money on gets layered upon layered upon layered about tax. For example, I have this cigar in my hand. This same cigar in Dallas, Texas costs me $10. This same cigar in Illinois, because of taxes, cost $15. 30% more for what? Taxes, and at the same time increasing property taxes, at the same time increasing sales taxes, for what? Mismanagement, greed. You see, when I was making little money, $25,000, $50,000, 75,000. By the way, no judgment on anybody out there making $25,000, $50,000, $75,000 a year. I just realized for the life I wanted to live, the dreams I wanted to experience, the lifestyle I wanted to provide my family, my wife, my parents, the people I love and care about, I wanted to provide this, but I could not live and survive in Illinois with an income like this. And I realized that the more money I make, it's unnecessarily taken away by unnecessary taxation. The more money I make, more unnecessary taxation. And I realized, I'm going back and forth to Dallas, Texas all the time. I have opportunities in Houston. I have opportunities in Austin. I have opportunities in San Antonio. I have opportunities in El Paso, Texas. And I've got opportunities in Dallas, Texas. Quite often, I'm on a plane once every other week to Dallas, back and forth to Chicago. And I'm often out of Chicago into Texas and back from Dallas, Texas to Chicago in the same day. So I'm asking myself, why am I spending 3-4 hours a day, 6 hours a day commuting to a city and state that I'm constantly and conveniently always at? Furthermore, I realized that the property values in Texas, in a real estate in Texas, was very attractive for us to have this amount of budget for this amount of house versus this amount of budget for this amount of house in Oak Brook, Naperville, in Chicago, Illinois. In other words, my dollar goes further, and more so, my dollar, it stays more in my wallet. So instead of me just pocketing that money, however, what do you think we can do with that extra money? What do you think we do with that extra finance? Well, for once, we can reinvest more back into our business. Instead of paying an unnecessary amount of $30,000, $40,000, $50,000 in income taxes in the state of Illinois, guess what? We can take that same amount of money and reinvest that into the business by creating jobs, by blessing somebody's life, by helping somebody pay their rent, their mortgage, their kids' tuition, their car payment, the food on the table, the roof over the head. I'd rather go to that direction, helping a family versus the government, who has obviously shown that they're poor stewards of the taxpayer finances. So these were some of the things I went through, a thought process and a checklist to go through to make sure I wasn't making an emotional decision. And just a quick update, we've been here for about 3-4 weeks now, and I love Dallas, Texas. I love Texas overall. And I'm a big believer in that home is where you make it. And one of the most frustrating things I've experienced in Illinois, and more so the proximity of living in Chicagoland area, is sadly gun violence. At the shooting of this video here in July 2021, it's been reported that Chicago has more mass shootings than any other city in America. And as a father, and as an entrepreneur, I do not want the people that I love and care about and the business I've built to be affected by any of that. Because already this year, in Chicago, I have agents all over the Chicagoland area. Two of my licensed life insurance agents have already lost their life due to gun violence. One was simply picking up their son, and the other one is getting carjacked driving Uber part-time. Both of these gentlemen, our agents who are with our firm, lost their lives in Chicago due to gun violence in 2021. I just don't want my family and kids around that proximity for that type of opportunity to creep up on them at all. Whereas here in Texas, the gun laws are radically different. Here in Texas, you don't know who's strapped. You don't know who's carrying. And that in itself is a deterrent for any criminal to say, you know what? I might rob this person, but I don't know if they have got a gun in the car. I might rob this person, but I don't know if they're concealed carry. I like having that great unknown in the criminal's mind, which the state of Texas allows us to live in. It's land of free and the home of the brave, right? Thank you, Texas, for allowing us to express our Second Amendment rights. Number two, what people do you surround yourself with to help cultivate and become deuces for you to become a first generation cash flow millionaire? Who are you taking advice from? Are they living the type of life you want to live? Are they somebody you like to become? Who do you spend the most time around? Are the people you're around the most chasing something every day? Are they still in the game? Are the people around you negative or positive people? Do they see opportunities to be great or excuses why they can't do something? Do they think in terms of problems or in terms of solutions? And to answer those questions for myself, I realized I was communicating a lot with the people in the C-suites of our corporate home office based here in Addison, Texas. More so, I realized that there's more people here in Dallas, Texas that were looking for our type of opportunity in business as well as a career, the potential to work from home, to set your own schedule, have high income, control your own destiny, serve people, help a lot of people with the areas of personal finance and money 101. I also realized too, there's a lot of transplants coming into Dallas, Texas with companies here recruiting people, and also governors and mayors doing good jobs of recruiting businesses here too as well to domicile in the city and or state. The language and culture of entrepreneurship, free enterprise, and capitalism is alive and well here in the great state of Texas. More so, my staff was inspired. Ivan, who's actually from Dallas, who I find in Chicago to do my social media, is here right back home right now. He's excited. His mom is excited. My son is gainfully, fully employed, is a young 20-year-old man. My personal trainer, Milton, selling his condo in Chicago, moving down here to the land of opportunity here in Texas, with potential clients down here. Fitness is a big thing here in the Dallas, Texas area. People want to be in shape. The sun is out. And what he realized is that not only can he coach people here locally or in a physical gym location, but because of the pandemic, he's learned how to coach other people online or across the world. And where his business was taking him, he was mobile and he can go anywhere. And obviously our friendship and relationship played a lot into that decision too as well. There's people here that are licensed life insurance agents in the city of Dallas, Texas, that want help, that need help, but they're lacking mentorship and a leadership example to follow. And just last night, we did a very informal meeting, say, hey, we're setting up shop in Addison, Texas. Whoever wants to come out, we posted stories on IG, and just so you know, 25 people out of nowhere came to our office to experience what we're about to do here in Addison, Texas, in the insurance industry, expanding business across the Dallas metro area. Bottom line, it's so good to be in a city and state where people are ambitiously hungry for what you have to offer. My big reason of moving to Dallas, Texas, you've got to figure out your reasons for your situation and for what you want in your life. Number three, what content are you consuming? What are you listening to? What are you watching? What are you reading? Here's some other questions for you to consider to improve the chances of you becoming a first generation cash flow millionaire by simply putting yourself in the right environment by creating a new financial reality for your family. When you watch something on TV or the internet, is it helping you grow? Do you consume personal development? Do you crave leadership development? Is what you watch just simply entertainment and or a waste of time? Or does it uplift you? Does it tear you down? Does it give you ideas? What music do you listen to? Is it positive or negative? Are you really listening to the lyrics? I have different music for different times. Music for creativity, music for focus mode, and music for working out. And of course, music for praise and worship. Also, are you reading books? Are you studying to get better at what you do? Do you consume too much social media and get wrapped up in other people's opinions versus finding out what the facts are? See, I believe one of the most dangerous things what's going on in America today is the controlling of media, content, things that you see, opinions that you hear, and voices that are amplified or sadly canceled. So when I come up into a topic that may be controversial, I'm processing through how I feel about it, where my opinions are, I've got to read today plenty of information on the same topic, so therefore I can start formulating my own opinion and start thinking for myself. When I made the decision to become an entrepreneur, when I made the decision to leave the Marine Corps and get involved in the insurance industry, there's a couple inherent things that I had to reveal to myself were just sad truths and misconceptions that potentially may guide me in the wrong way based on what I want to do and accomplish in my life. One of them, because I'm Filipino, was to say, education is everything. At least nobody can take away your education. But if you got a job because of your education and they take away your job, what good is that education? Now, getting education means more than just sitting in a classroom. Getting education means more than just getting a college degree or a master's degree or PhD. There's self-learning, there's learning through experience, where today I don't have a college degree. I had a 2.2 GPA in high school. The only reason why I did somewhat pass my test in high school was so I can be eligible to play sports. But when I realized that my future and my life is online, guess what I started to become? A great student of business, a great student of finance, because I know it directly would impact my family, my wife, my children. I became a good student because I realized that the information I was being fed was not fostering me a reality that I wanted to see. My encouragement to you, my exercise for you to consider, is start writing down and jotting some things that you grew up believing that's just programmed here in your head, and you're asking yourself, well, why do I believe what I believe? Who told me to believe this about this? Who told me to believe that about that? Ask yourself those tough questions And you'd be shocked to find the truth, to find the reality, as I did in my journey about money, about career, about business, about finance, about my faith. I found a lot of new answers to the newer questions I started to ask myself because I started becoming clear about what I wanted. As I wrap up this episode and think back on my 22 years as an entrepreneur in the insurance industry, I'm thankful and grateful for being in the right environment today. Why? The first 11, 12 years of my career was an environment of me, myself, and I as an individual salesperson, self-employed, and just stuck on my own personal production, my own calendar, not building anybody but myself. The moment I started thinking like an entrepreneur in terms of how can I find problems that a lot of people have and create solutions to fix those problems and then recruit and develop and build a team to massively create distribution to fix those problems, then I then became a first generation cash flow millionaire because it forced me to elevate my game and forced me to be conscious of the environment I was in, that I was creating, an environment that people want to be a part of, an environment I want to wake up and jump out of bed and be part of every morning. That's something my family would love to be a part of too as well. I cannot wait for us the next couple weeks to have our annual convention in Vegas. Now, throughout the pandemic, throughout this lockdown, our company, we're gonna be the first to do a national convention at the MGM Grand Arena in all of Las Vegas. We did this in Louisville 5 months ago. We're the first group to do a company convention in Louisville going through and opening up past this whole pandemic. And we're excited now to do this in Las Vegas where we have coming on stage, entertaining our audience, entertaining, there's a private event, entertaining our guys that's with inside our company. We got Sebastian Maniscalco, a comedian. We got Frederick Da Silva, an illusionist. We got Iron Mike Tyson talking to our leadership group. We got Mario Lopez hosting our awards gala night for all of our top performers of our company. We got business author Patrick Lencioni will be there as well. And then to top off our gala awards night, we've got Nicky Jam doing a performance just for our company. And all this was based on the foundation of our CEO founder, Patrick McDavid, who had a vision and now is become a reality simply because he chose to create an environment that was conducive to his dreams and his goals, and he didn't stop until that vision became true. In the next couple weeks, our company will be making history at the MGM Grand Arena. Now, I hope you can see how much changing and improving your environment can change everything about your life and the decisions you make in your life and the realities you have in your life. And sadly, many people, they go from year in, year out, the same old, another day, another dollar type mantra. Good people, good seed, good character, wrong environment, wrong industry, wrong career, wrong business. And if you challenge yourself to discover what that opportunity could be, watch how your dreams can quickly become true, just like it has for my wife and I. And I know if it can happen to us, I know it can happen to you simply by creating and changing your existing environment. Before I let you go, please check out this video here where I also break down the parable of the sower. Also, please check out this video here, how one simple trick is used by most millionaires. And that simple trick was used by Jeff Bezos, who recently went on his own shuttle, spaceship, Blue Origin, to go into space with his brother, with his family, but somebody won an auction and back now down to earth. And the look they have on their face is simply just priceless because they are living their dreams because they changed and improved their environment. That being said, guys, I'd love to know your thoughts, your comments, your feedback. You agree with me, you don't agree with me, I'd love to know. Drop them in the comment section below. And if you haven't done so, if you're watching this on Facebook, make sure you click like and follow our business page, Money Smart Guy. And if you're watching this on YouTube, make sure you click subscribe and hit notifications to be alerted the next time we upload our next episode. From Dallas, Texas, I'm your Money Smart Guy, and until we meet again, continue to live smart, continue to love smart, and be money smart today.